गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. आई डॉक्टर सपना अहलावत फ्रॉम एमजीएम एमबाई मेडिकल कॉलेज प्रेजेंटिंग अ पेपर ऑन द सीटी इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ लार्ज बाउल वॉल थिकनिंग. नाउ द डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस फॉर थिकनिंग ऑफ द लार्ज बाउल वॉल इंक्लूड लाइक नियोप्लास्टिक इन्फ्लेमेशन इन्फेक्शन और इस्चीमिया. इन द अर्लियर पीरियड स्टैंडर्ड बेरियम स्टडीज ऑफ द जीआई ट्रैक वर डन फॉर द डिटेक्शन ऑफ बाउल वॉल थिकनिंग. With the advent of CT has made it possible to demonstrate the true extraluminal extent of pathology and it has been highly valued in the evaluation of bowel wall thickening. McCarty and the Balthazar also suggest that we should carefully analyze the CT parameters like degree of involvement, pattern of attenuation and enhancement, presence of fat stranding, extent of thickening, symmetry of thickening, associated finding, avoid most of the pitfall, as well as provide a diagnosis of primary intestinal lesion or offer a pertinent differential diagnosis. The main aim of this study is to evaluate the role of contrast and computed tomography in the diagnosis and differentiate the malignant and benign large bowel pathologies. In this observational study, data was collected from the patient of suspected large bowel wall lesion who were referred to radiology department at MGM MY Medical College. A total of 50 patients were included and the informed consent was taken from each patient prior to enrollment in the study. We include all those patients who present with the symptom like altered bowel habit, and the patient with positive large bowel wall finding on colonoscopy or ultrasound. We exclude all those patients in whom the CT was not possible, like deranged renal function patient and the pregnant female, and who were not willing to give consent, excluded from our study. We also followed up to the therapeutic biopsy, operative diagnosis, histopath report, helping the confirmation of provisional diagnosis made on MDCT. Now coming on the observation and result part, overall most of the cases were reported in the age group of 41 to 60 year. Now the distribution of the age group in the benign bowel wall pathology, most of the benign cases were reported in the age group of 21 to 30 year. We see the 30.8% patient belong to the 21 to 30 year age group only, followed by the 23.1% patient belong to the 41 to 50 year age group. Now the distribution of age group in the malignant bowel wall pathology, most of the malignant cases were found in the age group 51 to 60 year, followed by 41 to 50 year, and none of the cases were reported in early age group, that is 10 to 30 year. Here we see also 35.3% cases belongs to the 51 to 60 year age group, followed by 29.4% cases belong to 31 to 40 year age group in the malignant bowel pathologies. The majority of the patient in the malignant lesion present with the perirectal bleeding, while in the benign condition, most common presentation were the loose stool and pain in abdomen. We see here also the bar chart also shows the perirectal bleeding present in 23.5% cases among malignant bowel lesion, and the benign bowel lesion majority patient present with the vomiting and the loose stool, that is 30.8% present with these symptoms. Let's discuss the location of bowel wall lesion. Among all the malignant lesion, most of the cases involve the rectum followed by combined location of the sigmoid colon and rectum. Among all the benign lesion, most commonly involved segment was long segment extending from the transverse to sigmoid colon. This bar chart shows the same thing. In the malignant cases, rectum involved in the 52.9% cases, while in the benign condition, majority of the patient, 23% cases, involve the transverse segment. Now, let's see the attenuation on contrast CT. The p-value for this is less than 0.05. It means it was statistically significant for the difference in malignant and benign lesion with respect to attenuation. Majority of benign lesion shows homogeneous attenuation, while in the malignant lesion, we saw the heterogeneous mixed attenuation. In this bar chart, we see the same thing. होमोजिनस एटिन्यूएशन इन द बिनाइन पेशेंट बिनाइन कंडीशन, वाइल इन द मेलिग्नेंट लीजन वी सी द हेट्रोजिनस मिक्स एटिन्यूएशन. नाउ लेट सी द बावल थिकनिंग ऑन सीटी स्कैन. द पी वैल्यू इज लेस देन वाज लेस देन 0.05 वाज दैट इज सिग्निफिकेंट फॉर डिफरेंस इन द मेलिग्नेंट एंड बिनाइन लीजन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू माइल्ड और मार्क थिकनिंग. मार्क थिकनिंग वाज सीन इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस बिलोंग टू द मेलिग्नेंट लीजन वाइल माइल्ड थिकनिंग वाज सीन इन मोस्ट ऑफ द बिनाइन लीजन ओनली. As we see in this bar chart also, 88.2% cases among the malignant lesion shows the marked thickening, while only we see the mild thickening in 84.6% cases belong to the benign lesion. Symmetric or asymmetric involvement of the large bowel wall thickening, the p-value was less than 0.05, that is statistical significant for difference in malignant and benign lesion with respect to symmetry of thickening. Most of the malignant lesion were associated with asymmetric thickening, while majority of benign lesion involve the symmetrical thickening. As we see here, asymmetric thickening in the benign in the malignant cases, that is 88.2% patient shows asymmetric involvement, while in the benign cases, 92.3% cases shows the symmetric involvement. Now, the extent of large bowel wall lesion, whether it was focal thickening or there was a segmental thickening or there was diffuse thickening, the p value for this is also less than 0.05, that was statistically significant. We see the focal thickening in most of the malignant cases. In most of the malignant cases, 76.5% cases shows focal thickening, that is less than 10 centimeter segment involvement. While in the benign cases, we see majority of the patient shows diffuse thickening. In this bar chart, we also see the malignant cases shows 76.5% cases shows the only focal thickening. While in the benign cases, 38.5% cases shows the diffuse or segmental thickening. Let's discuss few cases among our study. Sir, there is an axial section of the CT in which we see the circumferential bowel wall thickening of the rectum with narrowing of the lumen, which came out to be a benign inflammatory lesion on histopath. Let's discuss second case, asymmetric marked attenuation or thickening with the heterogeneous attenuation of ascending colon came out to be ascending colon cancer on histopath. Let's see the lymph node involvement and large lymph node involvement seen in both benign and malignant cases. And the p value was also more than 0.05, that was not statistically significant. Now we see the malignant and the benign, both were shows the enlargement of lymph node, and this was not statistically significant in our study. And the fat standing in the large bowel wall lesion, the p value was less than 0.05. And the statistically significant for difference in malignant and benign lesion with respect to fat staining, all the benign lesion were associated with the peripheral fat staining among all the entire malignant lesion. 70.6% shows presence of surrounding fat staining, while 29.4% lesion was shows absent fat staining. This is the bar chart shows the same thing, fat staining in the large bowel wall lesion. Let's discuss few associated finding. Most common site of metastasis in the malignant lesion was that of the liver, seen in the 17.6% cases, followed by lung and bone. There were no metastasis seen in 64.7% cases. And the obstruction of the bowel was present in 17.6% of the malignant, while in 15.4% cases in the benign lesion, it was absent in most of both benign and malignant cases. As per the observation of our study, among all the malignant lesion, the most common location was the rectum in 52.9% cases, followed by combined location of sigmoid colon and rectum. But Cize et al. Study done in Gujarat State of India also reported that most common malignant lesion involving large bowel was adenocarcinoma and rectosigmoid lesion was the most frequent site of involvement noted in 64% patient. Now coming on to the conclusion part. From the study, we conclude MDCT has a sensitivity of 100% and specificity of 92% and the positive predictive value of 94.4% and negative predictive value of 100%. From the study result, it can be stated that the MDCT has a high predictive value in the diagnosis and differentiation of benign and malignant lesion of the large bowel. Nature of bowel wall thickening, whether it was focal, segmental, diffuse, degree and symmetry of bowel wall thickening pattern, attenuation, and fat stranding are among the important parameters which help in diagnosis and differentiation of benign and malignant lesion in the large bowel. These are the references. Thank you.